Okay, welcome to the Chess Buddies Challenge, first round, and I play against Jeff Forever, Jens Hirneiser, who's a German Fidemaster, and he's a very, very strong blitz and rapid player, so I think the match is completely open, and I have no clue who's going to win, to be honest. So if I was a betting man, I would not know if a bet would bet on me or on him. He goes for the King's Indian, and if he goes for e5, I will just snatch it on e5. And play this somewhat boring endgame. Yeah, I played this line quite often, and yeah, I think it's nothing special, but I think it's just playable. And I like to play a little more technical positions, so I think he's pretty strong in more open positions. So let me go for that. Okay, knight d7 is a very good line. No, I have to remember the theory. I think knight d2 is the theory here. Knight d2. And I think now knight c5 and long castles, if I remember correctly. And then after knight d3, you can just go king b1 because knight f2 doesn't work due to rook f1 or something like this, if I remember this correctly. After knight f6, I just go bishop b3, so that's the idea of going knight d2. Yeah, so I think the main move is here is knight c5, and then there's a long line which is leads to some like roughly equal endgame. What will be important for me is to take the time wisely because it's a very unusual time control for online chess. So it's important to be smart with the use of the time. Well, I played knight c5, and I think now this is the line which I mentioned, knight d3 check, and white can just go king b1. And after knight f2, there is some things like rook df1 and some things like this. So I think the normal move here is bishop e6 or knight e6, which both lead to a more or less equal position. But yeah, I'm not particularly interested in the openings anyhow, so getting an equal position with the kind of position I like to play, it's perfectly fine for me. Yeah, I think after bishop e6, I'm supposed to take and go bishop e3. Yeah, if he takes back with the rook, then I will just go bishop e3 anyhow. And maybe there's a slight positional edge there. So I think the best move, as far as I can remember, is the move knight takes e6. And then I go bishop e3, and he can play knight f4, I think. I think there's even some weird line like knight f4, g3, knight g2. But after knight f4, I can also just take on f4 and go f3 with pretty equal endgame position. In any case, I'm happy that he thinks for quite some time, that he doesn't know all the theory here. And he goes rook e6. Yeah, rook e6 is not the book move, as far as I can recall. But I think I should go bishop e3 nonetheless to avoid knight d3 shenanigans. Yeah, I think bishop e3 looks pretty much normal, because if I go knight b3, you can take on e4. So therefore bishop e3, rook c8, and maybe then just king b1. If he goes knight d3 anyway, I think it's not too big of an issue. I could either go even king c2, maybe even just king b1, and then go knight c4 in the next move, or knight b3 for that matter. Well, in this position, I mean, the general plan is that black has a slightly worse bishop. And I can sometimes penetrate on the d-file. All right, so I could either now go f3 or king b1. I think these are the main options I consider. Um, I have to prepare for 93 stuff. So maybe I'm not really sure what is better, if I should go f3 or king b1. Let me go king b1. Maybe that's a little bit more flexible. And now my idea is to go knight b3 at some point. But I will probably have to go f3 at some point anyhow as well. So one thing that I realized now is that you might be able to go d8 right now. But I'm not sure what this position would be. Yeah, rook d8. The idea is if I go f3, I think he will just play rook d6 and say that that pin might be unpleasant. The other option I have is to go knight b3 to allow him knight e4. But yeah, I think that's also fine. Takes, takes, knight e4, bishop a7, b6. Yeah, I will do that. Let me see. I will just go on knight b3. Takes, takes. And if he goes knight e4, then I can go bishop a7, as I said. And at least I have this 2-against-1 on one wing. But the position is definitely unclear. So maybe king b1 was not the strongest move, and maybe I should have gone for f3 instead. So if we play this once more, I would probably go for f3 instead. Okay, I guess he probably has to take. And then the question is if he takes on b3, after which I can go ab, or if he takes on e4, and then I can either go rook d7, or I can go bishop a7. Now that I see rook b7, actually it's a move which I like a lot. Maybe this puts a little bit more pressure, or even rook d8 could be unpleasant for him. So that's something which I didn't see in advance, but which now makes a lot of sense. So if he goes knight e4, could maybe even go rook e8. So yeah, that's probably what I will do, with the threat of going bishop h6. And then if he goes back knight f6, I have a move like knight c5. Yeah, this looks pleasant, actually. This looks quite pleasant. So rook d8 is a threat anyhow. So probably the best thing he can do is to take on b3. And maybe after ab to even just go rook d6. Then it's takes, takes, bishop a7, and it's really better endgame for me. But I think in any case, the position is quite good for me now. At least I hope that's the case. One thing that I didn't see is that after knight e4, rook d8. Okay, I'm stopping at that line right now. Okay, now a7 is hanging and rook d8 is threatening. So I think the only reasonable move he has is to go bishop rook d6. And then I'm up for choice to either keep the rooks on the board with rook c1, which makes a lot of sense as well. Okay, so he disagrees and goes for b6. And his idea is that if I go rook d8, he has king d7. So I will just go rook d7 to attack another pawn. And if he goes a5, I will go rook b7, bishop c5, takes, takes, rook b5. And then I have a rook ending, which is probably quite good for me. So I think that's what's going to happen. So bishop c5, takes, takes, rook b5. And if he goes rook d6, I just go king c2. Okay, he surrenders the pawn immediately. I will just go king c2 anyhow. Now I should be a little bit careful not to allow him any counterplay here. I can go g3, f3. The question is if this is really the best thing to do. Another quite attractive option is probably just go rook a7. And claim that his king is not going anywhere. That's what I'm going to do. A7 to prevent king g5. And now I will threaten king c3. And okay, he lost on time, but I think the position was anyway pretty good for me. Okay, so now it's time for the rematch. He starts with e4. So yeah, I'll probably just go for the Philidor, which is my pet line for life. And let's see what he has up his sleeve against the Philidor. And he plays this g3 line, which is just not bad, actually. So it's one of the better lines against the Philidor, definitely. And goes for this knight d2. Okay, I will go for castles. And here I think black has different plans. One is to go knight e5. And another one is to go a5, a4. I think I will go for this a5, a4. Maybe here I even have this b5 option, because I think h3 is a little bit imprecise. So maybe I even have b5 here. Let me just do that. Because if he takes, I can take on e4. I thought maybe that's not true. Because he has queen d5, but anyway, he doesn't go for it. Probably he believes that I know the theory, which I don't. So I will just take. And if he goes ED, yeah, that seems reasonable to just go ED right now. Okay, he goes queen takes d5. That's a little bit surprising for me. So yeah, that's now a position which is definitely new to both of us. I will just go bishop b7 and then rook b8. And maybe go knight e5 on a good day. Castles, as I said, I will just rook b8. And yeah, maybe bishop f6, knight d4 is also a good idea. So I feel that the position should be decent. I mean, maybe not better or anything, but it should be okay for me. And yeah, if I go, yeah, I'll probably go bishop f6 and bishop f6 next, and then he has to retreat with the queen. And he has to decide if he wants to go f4. So he plays a3. I didn't see that move coming at all, but it makes a lot of sense. On the other hand, if I just give him the file, just go a5, it's also fine. The alternative would be to go bishop f6, ab, knight d4, bishop knight d4, queen c4, but I don't see a follow up there, so I will just go a5. Conceding the a file to him. And maybe go rook a8 in the next move then. Yeah, so that seems like a plan. Yeah, I think, as I said, my play is probably quite intuitive. We'll go bishop f6. Oh, that's a surprise as well. But now I think bishop f6 should be pretty strong. Let me see how he reacts to that. Because now, like with c3 also weakening the structure a little bit, this knight d4 is very annoying. Another idea that I have sometimes is to go bishop a6. But yeah, so for him it's a little bit tricky now to deal with this knight d4. Do you really want to allow that? I mean, at the moment there is no concrete threat, but at least I don't see one. But it could be a bit annoying. Yeah, so he decided to take measures against it with the move queen to d1. Yeah, and now it's also not clear at all what I should do. So I will just go rook e8. Make a normal developing move. Yeah, maybe that was not so strong because he doesn't have knight f4 because still c3 is weak. He could go cbab and a4, but yeah, I'm not sure that this is really what he wants to do. So yeah, my idea might be bishop a6 next, or for that matter, just Knight e5 and maybe then knight c4. Well, okay, he plays rook e1. And now if I go bishop a6, he wants to go knight f4. Yeah, that makes a ton of sense. Oh, but after, he just wants to go ab, probably. Ab takes takes, ab, cb, and here's the pair of bishops. Yeah, I don't want to end up in such a strategically worse position. So, not so exactly sure what I should do. One reasonable thing to do would just to improve the position of my bishop to bring it to g7, because this might have to happen anyhow if he somehow manages to go and knight to f4. So I will make some look for the king and bring the bishop to g7. Okay. So yeah, I don't know. That's a pretty complicated position, that's for sure. Okay, he plays bishop d2. Maybe this runs into knight e5. I suspect so. So I will just go knight e5 because I have a very strong threat. If he goes cb, I can go knight d3 and then maybe bishop e4. Yeah, that makes a ton of sense to me. So I think, okay, he goes queen c2 right now. Saying that I didn't really accomplish that much with the whole maneuver. Maybe that's true, but I have b3. Could be annoying, so I'll just go b3. And if he has to really go king queen b1, then it's definitely good for me. So I mean, the idea is if he goes queen b3, I have bishop e4, so maybe he has to go queen b1. But that position is definitely good for me, favorable. So I also threaten sometimes knight c4. So if I go knight c4 here, he still has a bishop move, and I don't really win anything on the spot. So that's why I think I will just go rook a8, intending to take on a1 and maybe go knight d3. If he goes knight d4 now, yeah, now it gets really complex. If he goes knight d4, maybe I have knight c4. If it was knight f4, then I definitely have knight c4, but I will take first Arnold, then he still has maneuver. Okay, I will then still go knight c4 right now. Probably goes bishop to c1. Or am I missing? I'm blundering some e5 tricks. That would be nasty. But I don't think that works. Yeah, okay, after bishop c1, so he's kind of saying, yeah, I don't have any direct threats against against e4, but on the other hand, he can also not go knight d5 right now because I can just take it, and the rook on e1 is unprotected. Yeah. So, yeah, now it gets tricky. We just go queen d7. But this e5 is also always a little bit annoying. Another option is to go takes takes. Yeah, let me just go bishop g7. For the moment, because for him it's also not so easy to make a move, so I think I should not worry too much about improving my position, because for him it's also pretty difficult to improve his. Should I go knight e5, followed by bishop a6? I don't know. But this runs into these things, so I'll just go knight e5. See what he's up to. Okay, he tries to grab my pawn. I'll just go queen a2. Maybe I threaten knight c4 right now, but now it's just a mess, and this is actually not the kind of position that you wanted to play. That's now a complete mess. He will take on c7. Oh, but I cannot take on b2. I didn't see that. Ah, that's annoying. So after knight c7, I probably have to go rook c8, but then he has even knight d5 back, so that was really bad. Like after knight c7, I'm just much worse. Knight c7, rook c8. Okay, unfortunately, he didn't go for that. So I will stay there with the queen and threaten to go. Oh, shit, I didn't see that. I'll have to go queen a8 if he goes bishop d2. Yeah, so that's obviously not what I wanted. Still, I mean, the position remains quite complicated, so it's definitely not over yet. He wants to exchange material. I'm not sure if I'm willing to give in on that request, but on the other hand, yeah, maybe okay. I will just give him that. Okay. Maybe I can strive for c5. This is now getting out of control. And now he outplays me. So well done by him on that. I still have. And this is now very, very, very bad for me. At least after queen f5, I still have bishop c8. So it's no direct problem. I could go queen d7 next. Okay, I will have to go for this, even though it's probably bad. Yeah, I'll have to go back here, and then I will have to go king g7 and run here. Okay, I mean, still I'm not so sure if he really wants to exchange that. Position is very annoying for me to play, of course. Now I'll just create some threats. Okay, I will go for that one. I think that ending. Oh, I think that was probably a mistake. That holdable. And I think now it's a draw. Okay, he can go all the way, but I can't always just follow him, and I think it's a draw. So it's good news. I'll just put the bishop back and forth, and I think, oh, I cannot lose it anymore. I think I can even wait here. I don't see anything which you can do. Okay, that was pretty lucky for me to escape in that game. Okay, next one. So I'm not so sure if I will go for the Philidor again, so that didn't really work out in the sense that I got a position which I didn't really like. And now he changes opening, so he doesn't want to go for the Dal King's Indian stuff anymore. But I think this is good news for me. So he now goes for something which he knows less. That's probably definitely not bad for me. Okay. Because g6, I play e3. Yeah, this is the line where I recently made the video about against Volokitin when he played f5. But f5 is not the move that most people play here, so I will just play a different line. And if he now goes d5, I will just go d4. And I suspect that, I don't know this line very well, but I played it a couple of times. So I suspect that this will not be a disadvantage. D4. And now Black has a ton of options, but I think in general the line is considered to be okay for White. So I will see. So if he goes e4, I can go knight e5. If he takes, then yeah, we get a more quiet position again. So I think he might go e4, but then I just go knight e5, and I think, yeah, probably objectively it's slightly better for White. Okay, he goes for the EDED line. And yeah. So takes, I guess I would just take back here. If he goes DC, I would take. Okay, bishop B4. Okay. I could just castle. It's definitely one feasible option, which maybe not too bad. Okay, can take on c3, but then I go just cd, bc. Or I could take on d5, take on c6, and castle then. Now that also makes sense, so I'm not so sure. Cd, knight d. Knight c6, knight c6, bc6, castles. And I'm a pawn down, but I think I like the position, so I'll just probably go just castles. Oh, sorry, this was cd the line, right? Yeah. Cd, knight d, castles. Cd, knight d, knight c6, bc6, castles. Just castles also fine. I mean, I'll just go castles. Should not think too long because it's a blitz game and this is not the most important decision of the game. I think I took way too much time for this decision. Okay, if he takes, I'll just go BC, as I said. And my structure is slightly worse, but I'm better developed and I have two bishops. So I think that should compensate for the disruption of the white pawn chain. If he doesn't take, then the point is I can go cd and knight c6 in some combination. I don't know exactly how yet, but I mean, one decent move probably castles. Yeah, so that's what he does. So now if I take, he goes knight e5, takes, and then I get the same position again. So I'll just take on d5. And after knight d5, I will go knight c6, I think. And if he takes on d4, then of course I can take back. And he wins back the pawn, but I have the pair of bishops. So that position will be a little bit better for me. So I guess knight e5 is probably stronger. But then I have a slight advantage in terms of the pawn chain. At least knight d5 would be a little bit more unpleasant for me to play against. Not sure if it's objectively stronger, but I feel that knight d5 might be more unpleasant to deal with. But okay, then I will go knight c6, bc6, knight, maybe knight e4, and just knight to g3, bishop f3. Well, the disadvantage in the pawn chain is substantial, and his bishop on b4 is also not particularly well placed for that case. So if he takes on d4, I will just, as I said, take back. And after bishop c3, queen c3, didn't give that much thought, to be honest, if there was even the option of going bc. Yeah, in that case, I wanted to just go queen g3. I think that's probably makes a ton of sense because I threatened bishop h6 in some lines. But he has queen f6 here. Yeah, I didn't see that, so maybe that was not the best continuation. My queen f6 is actually quite annoying. Okay, he goes queen b6. And maybe this position is not as good as I thought it was. I guess I have to give him that. Yeah. Could go queen b3, which looks a bit weird. Point is, if I go bishop c4, he just has bishop b6. And that's very solid. Okay, but then I have bishop h6. So I think I can go just bishop c4. And if bishop e6, I have bishop h6. I will just go bishop c4 and see what he does. In general, the placement of the bishop on c4 is, of course, quite good, as this annoys this knight. In particular, this tactical detail with bishop h6 in this position is very important. Okay, so he goes back to f6. If I go bishop h6, he now has knight h5. I will go queen b3. Just to annoy him, to play another technical endgame, because I had the feeling that this might not be to his liking. Yeah, I think the endgame is deceptive in the sense it's definitely better for white. And okay, now he gives me that. He will get a very strong outpost for his knight on d5. But he still has this weak pawn on e6, so it's just one weakness. And I'm not sure if that's enough to convert here. But yeah, okay, so now right now he already faces a difficult decision. Does he want to give up the pawn on a7 with rook c8? Yeah, he does. So if I take, go bishop a7, he just has rook a8. So that was not as difficult as I thought. I will just go bishop d2 for that reason. And then have this position of the bishop 3 squares away from the knight, which is often quite nice. And now bring my king. I think I should still have a small advantage. Maybe I could have gotten a bigger advantage, but I think the position is still sufficiently unpleasant for him. So I will just go king f2. King e2, king d3, and maybe at some point he will exchange all rooks, but even then, I mean, there is a small edge for white here. I'm going to go king f1. And I hope I don't have any connection problems here. Okay, he goes c6, I will just take that. I don't believe in that. So he wants to go rook b8 next. I will just go rook c1, rook c2. Because I don't want to play b3, because then he can come with a5, and that's a lot more unpleasant than if I have my rook on c1. Okay, I will just go king e2, see what develops. Okay, he plays a4, but I think he doesn't really want to go a3, so I'll just go rook c2. for the moment. Maybe bring my king to c1, that would be one plan, and then go rook c4. I think I will do that. So go king d1, king c1, and then have the rook free to go to play rook c4. Because whenever he goes a3, I will just go b3. It should be fine. So there's a slight positional pressure here on him. We'll just go king c1, as I said, and now go rook c4 in the next move. As I said, I will go rook c4. And now force him to make a decision. Either he goes knight b4. That's pretty ambitious. Okay. Can I take it? Okay, he also, I mean, he has no real threat here as far as I can see, so. Ah, here he threatens knight a2, so I didn't see that. So then this gets snatched. So if he goes rook takes, I have rook c3 and bring the king. Or can I go to the pawn ending? I don't think so. I will just go rook c3 and quietly bring the king. And yeah, the ending should still be a little bit better for me. So I guess king c2 is decent. Now I will go b3, I think, yeah, and prepare for the case in which he comes there. Okay, after c4 I have rook b7, so I'll go rook b6 now. And yeah, of course, it's now again just a question of time management for both of us. So it's a little bit unpleasant that we don't have enough time to really play that out properly now, but that's what it is. I will go rook b3 back. And I have no clue who's better in that endgame at y. Okay, I'll go h4. I will just go king c2. Okay, now he cannot really go. I think we don't do that anymore because I have a check. I think I have. And now I can go king c3. And yeah, the position is now. Okay, now I have to take my time, I think. I will take and go rook e4. Okay, he lost on time. That's unfortunate because this endgame was still very interesting. So he goes for e4 again. This time I will go for the Scandinavian. With queen a5. It's not really a very good opening, but yeah, in blitz it's definitely playable. So he goes for this bishop d2. I think I remember that there was some line like this, but I'm not very good in the theory of that line. There is even the move bishop f5. I think this is a very sharp line where I can go knight c6 and long castles. So yeah, I vaguely remember that line from my time when I was still playing more actively. Okay, it was f4. Can this work? Wow, it's amazing. I can go e6. Question is if I have something better than e6, something more direct. Could also go bishop e4, but then you can just take, so that doesn't work. So in this case, I would just go e6, but yeah, then he has queen f3. So I should really be careful now what I do, I think. So it's a good time to take a breather. Okay, but if he goes queen f3, at least he's not threatening really f5, because I can take back and go bishop h5. So if he goes queen f3, I probably play knight c6. Yeah, and we get a very different type of game, like the games that I got with the white pieces. So crazy, crazy position. Okay, now he threatens f5 again. I could even think about taking on c2. At first glance, it looks like a bit too much. I could also sack a piece for a couple of pawns. So the line would go knight c6, f5, knight d4, queen e4. Then that's very, very double-edged. Oh no, he doesn't have queen e4, so if he has to go queen d3, maybe I'll just do that. Okay, now it gets super complicated and extremely double-edged, and it might easily be that I miss something trivial. But yeah, so I can't play only boring games. If he doesn't do anything, I will just go long castles, and then I think my position is completely fine. Even if he goes like something like bishop g2, I will just go long castles, and even if he takes on c6, this kind of position is usually okay. So I think he has to go f5 or d5. And then I will go knight d4. So probably f5, knight d4, queen d3. But there I have queen e5 check, which I see now, which is maybe what annoys him as well right now. Because then he probably has to go king d1. King d1. And I think that position should be at least okay for me. This is very, very sharp and exciting. Okay. So knight d4 is a very strong threat. So he goes knight b5 first. I missed that completely. Okay, I will just go queen b6. And he will now go f5, I guess. Yeah, I missed that completely. That's what I said. So in this sharp position, it's easy to miss something. And now, I mean, I can go for knight d4 or just a6 fg. I can go for a6 maybe. Well, yeah, I don't know. Should I go knight d4, takes. I think this position is probably bad for me, just on feeling. So after a6, I get more counterplay, so I will go for a6. If he goes fg, I could go ab5, which is completely weird. Or I could even go hg. I might go for AB5, just the other one is a little bit too much, I think. So takes, it's obvious. And now I'm threatening to take on D4, but he could just play a move like C3, and then he's just much better. So that's obviously annoying. So yeah, C3, and he's just much better. So I misplayed that one. Could go after c3, I could go e5, which would be lead to even more craziness. And I think I will do that. Because I know I have to be quick. If he consolidates and gets two more moves in like knight f3 or something, then it doesn't work. So I really have to go e5 now very quickly. The idea is d5, knight e5, queen e5, rook e8, of course. So could go d, queen b5, but then I at least went back the pawn on g5. Would be annoying is the move g5. I completely missed g5. Yeah, so that's bad. Yeah, and that's not terribly difficult to spot. Ah, but after g5, oh, I'm lucky. So after g5, I have e takes d. So that's pretty lucky. Oh, this is a wild game. This is a wild one. Okay, I was thinking that I would meet that with rook e8. Because after e takes, he has knight g5, followed by a mate. The other move which I could play is e4. e4, knight g5 check, king g8, and then he has the very beautiful queen c4. So that doesn't work. And if I go rook e8, queen, it's the same thing, no? Wow, yeah, now I'm really in trouble. I would quite take that, I think, and concede that pawn, but that's of course absolutely not what I wanted to do, to just give away that pawn for nothing. On top, b5 is still hanging, so my position is just completely busted. After knight e5, I would take back and go rook e8. After d, I will also just go rook e8. But it's obvious that I don't have enough counterplay. And once he gets two, three more developing moves, I'm busted. So this position is definitely lost. But I think he should now play either knight e5 or d5 quickly. And I'm happy for every moment that he waits for one of these two moves to be played, because I think it's clear that I'm just much worse in these positions. So exactly sure why he's has not yet played d or knight e5. Maybe he's pondering which of the two is better. But I think there will not be such a big difference. I would lean towards knight e5 because that liberates the f file. So I think the line which I would play in his shoes is knight e5, knight e5, d5. But for whatever reason, he doesn't play it. Yeah, okay. So can I do something else? I don't think so. So let's take, and I will go rook e8, of course. And then he has bishop e3 planned, I think. Rook e8, bishop e3. Ah, yeah, bishop c5. Okay, that's good to spot that one. But yes, the position is of course extremely bad. Pretend to play against the e5 pawn. And I'm decently happy to see that, to be honest, because now at least I get an endgame where I'm clearly worse, of course, but we can still fight. And g4 is still hanging, so it's not like that's totally obvious. I think he should not have exchanged there and went for that endgame, even though of course it's still very good for him. Okay. Okay, now this is an important move, actually. I should maybe go knight e4. Then he has bishop f4. So I think I will just go rook d8. And after bishop f4, I will go rook e4. And then if he exchanges everything, okay, so maybe I can somehow survive. Okay, takes, takes. Let's go. I mean, this endgame is bad. But yeah, I think it's better than the position I had before, so can live with that. Question is if I should exchange one more rook or not, and I'm not sure. I think I will go knight d5, just to offer him that trade, because I'm not so sure that's what he wants. I mean, of course, the position remains very bad. I will go king f7, followed by bishop e7, bishop f6, in case he goes king d4. So after, okay, that's another possible move. I'll bring my bishop to f6 nonetheless, just to annoy him a little bit. And he even doesn't give me that, so that's annoying for me. I will go h5 to just exchange some pawns, maybe. Yeah, but he has this b4 and b5, and I'm just busted, right? Yeah, well played, bro. Not so much I can do here. It just makes some moves, right? Gotta play on. It's a blitz game after all, so. After bishop d4, I have. Okay. Not sure if that's exactly what he wanted. I even have king e6, maybe. After king e6, he has rook d3. No, no, this was bad. Okay, now it gets very low on time, and it's just basically a gamble. He doesn't have access to these squares yet, so. He has rook e8 check. No. Okay. I have a rook c3 check. So I will snatch that pawn. Okay, I'll give another check, see where he runs. So if he runs in the direction of the pawn, I will try to mate him. He stays in the center. Okay, one move that he doesn't anticipate is h3 now. So that was a good move. So I'll still go for h4, h3. Yeah, that's now way too little time for this kind of position. You can kick me back. There we go to c4. Okay. Check. Okay, that doesn't work. So I will wait for him. Oh, you can go b5. Okay, I'll just go check c3 check. Maybe hoping to get king f3 in next. Can you run to d1? Guess you can try. Oh no, I ran into the check. Oh no, how stupid. I should go rook a2, of course. Didn't see it, so thought lucky me, but maybe not. Okay, so I don't know if you can run there. I take. Of course, given the match situation, he has to try this anyhow, but I'm not sure it works. I'll go here. And okay, I cannot take it. Damn it. OK. Okay, so I think it will end in a draw now. Wow, at least that was entertaining, I guess. Oh no, I messed that up. Okay, Bishop, I thought you went rook h6. Okay. Yeah, okay. So, fifth game, let's go on. There were many mistakes, of course, at the end. And you could see that quite clearly. He goes back to the King's Indian. I doubt that he will let me exchange on e5 once more, because I think it's clear that this position is not what he wants. So he wants a fight, and therefore he will play some other move. I was anticipating that. I'll just go castles. After e5. Yeah, I don't know this position, to be honest. I will just go d5 and bring my knight to d3 probably from f3. I think this is how you typically play this kind of King's Indian stuff. You can go knight h5, but I'm not overly worried about that. So yeah, I will just go knight d3, as I said. And yeah, he goes for a very solid setup and a long game. It's definitely clever, because he doesn't want to lose one more game, or the match would be over. So after f5, I will just go back to f2. Oh, I think there's also the idea of going knight f2. So yeah, I'm not so sure I should play that position. So maybe I go b3, a3, b4. It's a little bit slow, but better than nothing. Yeah, I think that's what I will do. I will go b3, a3, b4. So if he goes f5, f4, I will just go b3, a3, b4. And if he goes g5, I always have just knight f2. Yeah. So after this very complex tactical battle, now a strategic struggle. He will go f4 at some point. So I guess maybe even now. And I will just use this setup with knight on f2. Now this will be a complicated one for sure. So I'll go b4 and then see what he does. So I attack on the queen side, and he tries to attack me on the king side. And well, it's a complicated battle. Another idea that he has is to sometimes go f takes e. Oh, he goes c5. That's always the kind of moves which I miss in the King's Indian. C5, really. If I take, he goes bc. I think that's probably not exactly what I'm aiming for. So probably let that one live and go b4, prepare b4. I cannot go b4 myself. Ay. Or can I? If I go b4, takes. Knight b5. That should be fine, no? Let me just see. I mean, basically his whole intention was to prevent before, but I will still go for that. So we'll see how that pans out. If he goes ab, I know he'd probably go ab, but I even have knight b4 as one possible move. Not sure that I will go for that though. It also looks fine. I mean, the other one is just go knight b5. And he has queen d8. Knight b5, queen d8, and if I then go something like this, okay. So I will go knight b4, removing the protection from my king side. But I think I'm relatively quick on the queen side, so I don't feel that onslaught on the king side that much. Because he still has some moves to go. Yeah, I think this is one decent option. Let's go for queen b6 check. Not sure if you can do it in this order, because of the queen b6 trade, I might have c5. And followed by, usually in this kind of position, it's good for white to exchange pieces. Oh, sorry, if I go, okay, could go bishop e3, f4, bishop f2, g5. He's still relatively slow, I would say, so. But that's a position which I'm not confident in my judgment at all. So could be that after f4 I'm just busted or something. But I have the feeling that this c5 is relatively quick as well. So okay, he seems to agree on that, and he goes for queen b7. But now I will just try to play for mass exchanges with queen b3 followed by queen b6. I think that's a decent enough plan. Maybe I will go rook b1 first. Now he shows his intentions, and I will just go knight e4. I think that's probably what I should do. I think the position should be now quite decent for me. If he goes knight h5, I can go rook b1, knight f4, bishop f1. And I'm still not under any direct threat, so that's good, because this means I cannot easily blunder stuff. And my plan is very easy. I'll just go rook b1 and queen b6. So I think it's probably a bit better now for me. Okay. Yeah, the main idea of bishop f5 is to prevent rook b1, I guess. So, can I go c5 immediately? Maybe. Maybe that's what I want to do. c5, bishop takes, f takes. Knight takes, you cannot even play, I think. So knight takes, bishop takes. I go c6, and I threaten queen b7 very strongly. So I think I can go c5 here. Takes. Oh, that's complex. Maybe it's also not needed. Oh, yes, this rook b8 as an intermediate move. I should not forget. But I will just go c5 here. So we'll see. If he takes, I'll just take back. So that's clear. And the king's Indian, it's different. You have to be quick. So I think that's why like c5 is at least topical. Not sure it's the best move given the match situation, because it leads to more complex play. But after rook b8, I just have queen c4, so that's not a problem. If he takes twice on e4, I have c6, with the idea of going queen b7. And I threaten, of course, knight takes d6. So he has to move somehow. Okay, I will take. And go c6. Yeah, and I thought in advance that this position should be unpleasant for him. But now, of course, the tactical trickeries come. That was a very, very strong move. So he threatens queen takes d5 or bishop takes d5. And at the same time, he threatens to go queen e1. One option I see is to just go king f2. Which protects against queen e1. I'm not sure. Probably this was a little bit too much what I did there. So if I go, I have to probably go king f2. Because if he takes, I have bishop c4. I still have this annoyingly advanced pawn on c6. So probably it will go bishop d5, bishop c4, takes takes and d5. And now I thought I should probably go queen b3. I will do that, queen b3. And yeah, I don't think I will ever have more than a draw here, but a draw would be enough to win the match. So I'm tempted to go queen b7 here. Queen a2 check, king g3, e4 check, king h3. I will do that, queen b7. Because he just has this check on a2, and then I can run. And I hope that I will be able to give a perpetual. It looks like a perpetual, to be honest, if he goes a2. E4, king h3, as I said. And then I'm threatening queen c8. So threatening queen c8, queen d7. And at the same time, I'm threatening c7, so it's not easy for him to play. So the good thing is it's much easier for me to play the position than it is for him right now. Because on top of facing these hard decisions, he needs to make sure that the game doesn't end in a draw. But yes, maybe d4. D4 seems the best option. Then I have check. It's a very long line, and I have supported, I think, something at the end of that line. I will just go queen c8 check first for sure. And queen d7 check. Okay, I should be very careful because he has. I will go queen d7 check. Ah, if he has bishop e7, I have c7, I guess, now. Yeah, that is sufficiently annoying. Okay, now I can just take it. And promote. Okay, I think we still play the last one, but yeah, I won the match, so I'm very happy about that, of course. And yeah, now I will go for Aljechin's defense, which is the other love I had as a kid. So let's see how that pans out. And yeah, okay, so this is the quiet line, which is quite a decent line for white. Yeah, it's now a little bit different because the tension is out. So, castle and go knight c6, maybe next. So I just vaguely remember these lines. Here. Yeah, so I think you should go knight c6, bishop f6. Okay, I will go bishop f6. Okay, he doesn't buy that because I can't really take on d4 because h7 is hanging. I get that, so I'll just go rook e8. And maybe g6 next. So yeah, I don't know. It's tricky. Well, it's completely different mood right now, and you tend to get too relaxed, of course, after this, after the match is decided. So it's a little bit strange to play on, to be honest. Can I at least get my knight to b4? He will go bishop b1. And now I will regroup my bishop to g7. What he has maybe has knight e4. Bishop g7, bishop f5, bishop g5, f6. Doesn't go for that. So I will. So this bishop is my problem. So I would like to exchange that one. Not exactly sure how I can accomplish that though. C6 d5 to stop him a bit. Yeah, I'm absolutely not sure how to play this position. 94, yeah. Should I go bishop g7? But I really want to exchange that bishop, and it's somehow I don't see how I can do that. So I'll just go d5. And after c5, I have knight t7, and then I don't know, the knight has to be rerouted. One possible way would be to go knight f8, knight e6, knight g7, bishop f5. That is a very slow plan, but at least it's a plan. So if he doesn't show any plan, then that's probably what I will do. Just f8, knight e6. Just now show this knight f8, knight e6, knight g7. And yeah, I suspect his plan might be to go f4. And goes knight c2. That's interesting. Because now I can exchange this bad bishop. So bishop f5, knight b4, ab, knight a2, bishop b1, rook b1. But I lose a pawn. I lose a pawn. Is it worth it? I don't know. Or should I just take and go for the I would take and go for knight e6. And then go on knight g7. I mean, you can go f4 g4 now, but that's also pretty risky. And if he doesn't, I will go for that plan that I just mentioned to get the knight to b7 and to go bishop f5 next to finally exchange this bad bishop on c8. So this is strategically, of course, very desirable because his pawn chain here has a black pawn on d4. And so I basically attack that pawn now and he needs to defend it. So that's why he goes bishop d1, retreating that bishop. Go even h5 here because I feel that at some point g4, g5 might be unpleasant. So I will go h5, even though that's slightly weakening my structure. So then I will go queen d7 next. And yeah, we'll see. We'll take it from there. So let's see what he does. He goes bishop f4. As I said, I will go just queen d7, connect the rooks. And now I have to find a plan. So one plan could be to attack the pawn on d4 somehow. Another plan could be to sack on h3 in the right moment. Because at the moment, like his pieces, especially these two rooks here, they are not well coordinated. So if I sack now, then he just takes rook e1. That's early. Just go back to e6. And I will go h4 next, I think. And then go back to f5. So that's just a temporary factor that my bishop was kicked back. Okay, now he comes with bishop e5. I should have seen that coming, but I didn't. I can take it. This is my good bishop. I think I have to live with the fact that the good bishop is gone. So I will just take it. Now I could go f6. I could just go, yeah, just go king h7 first to prevent queen h6. And then I'll go f6 and bishop f7, and position is probably still around equal. The only thing that's slightly annoying now is this pawn a5, which is not so typical of Aliechin positions. So that might be a problem because I can never exchange all rooks, because then the pawn on a5 is weak. So maybe I have to go f6, he goes back, and then bishop f7. Or if I want to be smart, maybe I play queen c7 first. Oh wow. Yeah, that's completely ridiculous. I missed that. Wow. I'm not sure if it's working, but it's completely ridiculous that I didn't calculate it. Wow. Well spotted, I would say. Could go f6 first now. I'm not so sure what this has accomplished. I think f6 looks very reasonable to me. After queen d3, I always have queen f7, so there is now not really a point to that. Yeah, not sure. So after f6, now the rook is hanging. He has to go back. He has to go. If he goes back, I have knight h5, of course. So maybe he should now take on g6. Yes, I'll take back. And now go. If he goes queen c2, I have bishop f5, I think. Okay, not sure if I really have that move because after bishop f5. He has knight f5. Knight f5, fe. Wow, I don't want to calculate this, to be honest. So, but maybe I have to go for it. Ooh, this is now really dangerous if I play bishop f5. Knight f5, f takes e. He has a lot of different checks. Yeah, but I'll go for that. I don't care. So I'll go for bishop f5. Let him show me what he's got. So I think I'll go for that, even though it looks really insane. I have no clue if he has a winning combination here, but I didn't see anything on the spot, so I felt why not to try, especially in the situation where the match is decided. The queen g3 check, I have king f6. Okay, goes for that one, then it's basically the more materialistic approach. I run back to g8. And I'm not sure if he wants to swap the knight for my bad rook on e8. Yes, he wants, but now he's stuck with a bad position. Okay, so that's comforting to know that. Oh wow, I didn't see that one as well. So I'm missing way too much. That's quite obvious. Okay, now go for king f7. This gives me some time to breathe. Can't take because of rook f3. Can go right here, yes. Okay, I'll just go here. Let's see. He might have queen g4, but then I have knight f5. And then I get e3 in. So that's not advisable from his point of view. And he also doesn't really want to exchange. So I think this was decently well played. So that's definitely into knight f5 and the game is over, I think. e3 is coming and it's over. Okay. Okay. Thanks.
When you have stress, play chess. When you fall on your ass, play chess for a real deal, for Christian seal.